kicking YouTube. It's your boy Ian. Welcome to the first installment of Inside the Hive, behind the scenes look at Kalamazoo College football. It's currently 9:47, and we have our end of the season banquet today. So come along for the ride. So right now my suit is a little wrinkly and dress shirt, so I'm gonna throw it up, turn on the shower, kind of steam it out. Hopefully we get some of the wrinkles out. All right, I got everything out of the shower. I also took a shower. As you can see, the hair's kind of crazy. But let's go get ready for this banquet. All right, so we're kind of just chilling for a little bit. My roommate Jack, he's in the shower. I think Blake just got up, and I have a nice suspicion that I don't think Josh and Moat are up yet. But let's go check it out. Good morning, Moat.
Good morning, Ian.
Good morning, Josh.
I liked it better when we was low key. Now you telling all your friends that I'm different, ain't the old me. Taking these drugs, I'm at the OD. Can't tell me that you loyal or you love, gotta show me. Locked up in pain and you my code D. For all the time that we waste, we gon' need some matching rollies. Girl, would you ride if it's a stolie? Girl, would you ride if it's a girl, I got some bad luck with love, so don't judge. You say you the one, so that makes two of us. You know I got some problems I don't really trust. Took a little minute for my heart to adjust. I know you got some problems you don't really trust. You don't wanna be the one to fall for a scrub, but it ain't what it was. It is what it is. Love it when I pull up, but you hit it when I dip.
See, you
drive away?
I mean, we got like...
He was about to just drive away.
Yeah.
She know I be stressing cause my brother's in the bricks. You know how I'm living, so I gotta take risks. Think I'm with some stick, but I'm probably making hits. I liked it better when we was low key. Now you telling all your friends that I'm different, ain't the old me. Taking
out for good.
The earrings.
Out for good?
For good.
I don't believe it.
Well, they're gonna close up after this 3 hours.
They're going in right after.
They're gonna close up after this 3 hours.
3 hours? Really?
Probably.
All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started. So if everybody can find their seats.
It's been two tough years in which we could not do these kind of events. But I can tell you, Coach Sorbo was ready to go. It literally took a couple of minutes since the announcement went out saying that we can host these kind of events. And he was calling, inviting me to this event. He was ready, ready to go.
Drugs, I'm at the OD. Can't tell me that you loyal or you love. Gotta show me. Locked up in pain and you my code D. For all the time that we waste, we gon' need some matching rollies. Girl, would you ride if it's...
You started all 10 games this season, tallying 20 tackles, 5 TFLs, 1 forced fumble, 1 fumble recovery, 1 pass breakup, and he was named MIAA Defensive Player of the Week, first performance against Oberlin, and he was second team All-MIAA selection for defensive line, and it is my privilege to announce the defense MVP for the 2021 season, senior defensive lineman, Isaiah Fleming.
A big part of our work week as an offensive staff was figuring out how to get this young man the ball, and then a big part of the talking on the headphones during the game was what are they doing to take that young man away from us. Your 2021 offensive MVP from Muskegon High School, Mr. Bubba Wilson. He's quickly emerging as one of the top performers, not only in our conference, but in the country at his position. Last season, he had 10 touchbacks on his kickoffs, converted 55% of his field goals, and with a long of 40 yards, while also converting 8 of 9 point after attempts. His best performance, however, was on the punt team, where he averaged 39 yards per punt, which was second by a very short margin in our conference. and was good enough to put him at 24th in the nation for punt average as well. He had a long punt, 69 yards, accounted for 12 fair catches, 14 punts inside the 20-yard line. I'd be remiss if I also didn't mention he converted several fourth-down conversions on design fakes for him, for our team, and had a long rush of 27 yards on one of those conversions and was eventually tackled by the returner, but if you ask him, it should have been a touchdown. I can't imagine a better candidate for this year's special team's most valuable player. I'm excited to see how he improves for years to come. Please help me in congratulating this year's special team's MVP, sophomore kicker and punter Ian Burr.
To put this in a nutshell, guys, this is the guy that we can put up on a pedestal and say, do it like him. See what that guy's doing, do that. As you look through the previous winners here, every single one of them is very successful in their field, and that's not a coincidence. Our Mary Jean Arnold Award winners this year from Cass Tech High School, Mr. Jameson Brown Jr., and from Vicksburg High School, Mr. Austin Bresnick.
Yeah, Ken Moody was a teammate. Unfortunately, obviously, left us too young, but he was an outstanding student and competitor, which it says on the award. So the recipients are obviously, it's important that they be outstanding students and competitors. Kevin Moody is one of the toughest SOBs you've ever met. it was an honor to play with Kevin. Was a good friend, so it's my pleasure and honor to get this award. This year's winner was a four-year starter on the offensive line, rock star in the classroom, plans on attending medical school after getting some clinical experience after graduation. So this year's winner, the Kevin Moody Award, is Walker Chung.
Yeah! Moving on to the Ed Baker Memorial Most Outstanding Newcomer Award. A little over 8 years ago, Kalamazoo College and its football program lost a very good man and a coaching legend after a lengthy fight with prostate cancer. Ed Baker coached the Hornets for 19 seasons. I had the good fortune of meeting Coach Baker and getting to know him just a little bit before he left us, and I will always appreciate his timely advice, words of encouragement, and an unconditional support. He is someone I will always hold in the highest esteem. After his passing, I felt it was important to honor Coach Baker within our program. With the blessing of the Baker family, we created the Ed Baker Most Outstanding Newcomer Award. This award recognizes the first-year football player who has displayed exceptional mental attitude, determination, and daily dedication to the success of the Hornet football program. I'm going to ask Coach Baker's son, Dan, to come back up here and present his father's award.
These are tough awards to give back. So this year's, it was two winners of the Ed Baker Award. Again, it's my honor to each year to do this in the years since my dad passed away. So this year's winners, the first winner started every game at multiple positions as an offensive lineman. As a big, smart, athletic player. Showed great promise in his first year, and I know the coaching staff and teammates expect great things from him in the future. I'll move on and introduce the second, and then obviously you'll probably know who these are going to be after I give these explanations. But the second winner, again, another freshman, given it's the outstanding newcomer award. Tough and smart, played in all 10 games, had 29 tackles, 4 tackles for loss in the pass breakup, has emerged as a strong leader and another individual that I know the coaching staff is looking forward to for great things and great leadership in the future. So this year's winners of the Ed Baker Award are Brendan Schaefer and Carson Dines.
Spin so it's like,
oh no,
you can't spin it on the point. Like, if we can get it
like this, then
like spin it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Get in there, Miller. All right, we'll spin Miller around.
Whoa,
balance.
1, 2.
got called. Pass my assists on the court, we gon' ball. Got a call from the gang, said they finna break the law. No, I gotta go, no, I gotta get involved. Break up, make up, we done been through it all. Crawl far, walk, stood 10 toes.